Reads as is, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Do not let your hearts be troubled and do not be afraid. I want to commemorate my aunt's life in a hopeful way, although today may be a day of grief. We should not let that take control over the fact that today we're celebrating the life of dear mom. Today we come for someone we all love, and it shows with everyone's presence here today. We are all here because in one way or another, she has impacted every single one of our lives. Even though it hurts, let's not let today become a day that is filled with sadness. She was a light everywhere she went. I can tell you that Thea is not gone. She left a piece of her in every single one of us.
Beautiful.
I never understand. God has a different purpose for each and every one of us. Even though we may not see the purpose, God always has been there in the middle of it. Let us thank God for the borrowed time He gave her to us, because it was a privilege, and now it was time that He called it back home. Thank you.
Thank you so much. We appreciate you very much. We have a special song that is going to be dedicated family, and listen to the song, please.
I come to the garden.
it's just special when it comes from your heart.
I'd just like to thank everybody for being here. I know these are very strange and difficult times, but it means a lot to have everybody gathered today. And my mother's love was unconditional and unending, and her life revolved around service for others, never hesitating to help anybody who needed it. In the decades she spent working as a nurse practitioner, she saved many lives and positively impacted countless more. She overcame unbelievable odds time and time again throughout her life and always rooted for the underdogs. And she was the strongest person I've ever known. She was a force of nature and my biggest supporter and the person who loved me most in life. And it's gonna be difficult moving on, but I know she wouldn't want me to mope for long, but that's about it. Thanks again for everybody for being here.
Thank you, everybody, for being here tonight. It means a lot to us. She'd have been here all week, but I couldn't work up the courage or nerves to see her until 2 o'clock this afternoon. No, actually, it was, I don't know what time it was, 11, 10, I don't know. Anyway, when Augustine got her all ready, he asked me to look at her and see what I thought. And the first thing was, that's not my sister. I want to thank Raphael for letting me put this whole service together, and I hope that it's something that you and the kids like. And I know my sister would be happy just that I did her service for her, and I did the best that I can, hoping that she'd love what we did. Of course, she didn't have any polish on, and the first thing I asked Augustine, I said, "Does she have polish?" He goes, "No." Does she want polish? I said, "Yes, but she'd kill me if I showed her any polish on." So he did the nails for her, and we're supposed to do the reds. I said, "Okay." And thank you too, because Raphael let me pick out her outfit with the help of Marissa, because I had to send Marissa pictures. At least I went to her favorite store, Lane Bryan. So, I'm going to miss her. She was not just my sister, but she was my best friend. And my mother, she always liked to tell me what to do, but that's what sisters are for, especially when I'm the youngest. But I remember when I first went to the hospital, she was texting me and she's like, "Don't be scared. She'll be okay." She goes, "I'm just here taking it easy, watching TV." And she goes, "And I'm in God's hands, so it'll be all right. Just don't worry about me, please." It hurt so bad because I couldn't do anything. And of course, when she was in the hospital, she was thinking about my brother that passed away in December. And she's like, "I wish I could have helped him." And now it's just David and I. Michael's just our foster brother. But biologically, it's just David and I now. I just want to let my nephews and my nieces know that I love you all very much with all my heart. And none of y'all have mothers anymore. But I'll be your mother. Because I know that's what my sisters would have wanted. And Grandma, because Grandma always told us, "You need to watch after the kids." But when my sister Debbie died, she's like, "You have to promise to be in touch with the boys because they don't have a mother anymore." And same thing, my sister Lolly. Myra and I got to go to our nephew's wedding. I think it was last October, I feel. And so Myra and I went to represent the family. Maybe that's what our mother would want. And now that my sister's gone, Myra and Manny, Marissa, you know, I'm here for you. Marissa, you don't have to worry about her calling you Betty Sue anymore. She always called Marissa Betty Sue.
Thank you. Thank you, Delphia. Esther, my sister, sent a letter for you guys, so I'm gonna read it for you, okay? Says, hello, my name is Esther Alberti. Thank you for being here for my cousin Myra. Growing up as a Picasso, we didn't have much time to spend with family, relatives. It was like maybe one time every many, many years apart for us. Each family moved around in the ministry or mission field. It wasn't until 2006 that I began to actually go to visit my cousins. Myra was Myra. From the first time I met her at the age of 11 years old, the girl came out with power and a big smile. She was wearing some whitish furry coat like a movie star. And her words to me were, I'm gonna grow up and be rich and wear diamond rings. Who could make that up about Myra? The girl worked her brain and got what she wanted. As an adult, I didn't get to meet up with Myra often. But when we did, she made it challenging and fun. And at the same time, I listened a lot, but when I got the chance to speak, my cousin gave me full attention. She was like the most of our family is. Very hospitable, caring, and giving. She loved to talk and carry a very good conversation. I kid you not, the last time we were on the phone, it was like from 10 a.m. to 7 or 8 p.m. California time. We never ran out of things to talk about. I'll never forget the time we were on the phone one evening and I heard her really strange sound coming from her end. Normally I would have kept my thoughts to myself, but this really sounded weird. I said to her, what the heck was that? To which she replied, what? And I said, that weird sound. She laughed and said, oh, that was me sucking up my oxygen after talking so much. I ran out of breath. We had a few things in common. We know how to shop, we enjoy talking when we do, and we would know how to go over curbs like professionals. No lie, we were meeting up with one of our cousins, Susanna, for lunch. It was a rainy day, but nice. Myra was driving, and I'm watching while she's driving. Oh my God, I see a big triangle island. We're approaching, and I'm listening and watching, thinking, does she see that? No, she didn't. Next thing I know is I'm saying, oh my God, Myra. I was shocked, and both of us are laughing as we are driving over town in a fancy car. Myra didn't you see that? No, you should have told me. And to top off the car, we get off the car and she starts walking in front of me, and I'm looking at her walk, really strange. Myra, what's wrong with your leg? She says, nothing's wrong with my leg. Then why are you walking like that? She replied with a chuckle, oh, my shoes are too big. I really liked these shoes, but they didn't have them my size, so I bought them today. One of my last text to her while she was in the hospital was, you need to get better. If I go there sometime in the summer, I want to see you walking on a size 8 Louis Vuitton shoe. Myra would upset me sometimes, but I understood my cousin. She was like the story of the lion who scared everyone, and my beautiful cousin roared sometimes, but it was because she had a big thorn stuck in her heart. She was in pain, but you know what that, but you know what, she's not in pain anymore. She would text me from the hospital, don't worry, I'm not gonna die. I've been through worse. You watch, God's going to heal me. Myra, like myself, was not perfect, but one thing I know about my cousin, she had faith. She trusted her healing God's hand many times over on this earth. Only this time God chose to give her complete healing. He took that thorn out of her big heart and took her home. She spoke just like me. I'm not afraid to die. I know God's got me. He's going to heal me, and he did. He gave her. God gave her the ultimate healing. That's what he did. I love you, Myra. I already missed you so much. I'll see you when I see you, prima. Love you for loving. Thank you for loving and caring for my cousin. That's it.
And the joy we share. as ever.